because and that is the point. They do not feel we are Americans.
Yeah.
And they don't think that we should have a vote. And they're doing everything they can to stop it.
Okay. I don't know what I, you know what? I take my cues. I've been reading all morning, just tweets, Cheryl and Eiffel, Latasha Brown, people that I respect that have been in the trenches that, you know, are saying they are more energized than ever, that they are, I think they are, whatever analogy you want to make, poked a sleeping bear, they have, you know, they're going to create a backlash like they haven't seen before. Between that and Roe v. Wade, don't go predicting. You know, you're definitely, Republicans are going to definitely take the majority in 2022. What do you guys think? How are you feeling about all of it?
I feel like turnout is not the problem. I feel like turnout has never been the problem for Black people. I feel like the reality is that Black people always vote. And that yes, turnout is important because it's really hard to argue with millions and millions of votes. But as you've seen, they're going to argue with anything. So we can't preemptively stop what are going to be ridiculous, unfair, and completely not factual attacks. And we do need to make sure everybody is out there to vote. And that's all important. But we have to stop these Republican legislatures from creating a situation where it doesn't matter if we all vote.
Yeah,
that's right.
That's and I think that as much as I want to praise this agenda and praise all the amazing work that this administration has done,
yeah,
it is very important that we all stop and recognize all that work will go away. It's all out the window at the end of this year.
Yeah.
If we do not stop them now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Black people, we're patient. It's taken us 400 years to get to $7.25 an hour. If there's one thing you can't say about Black people is that they're not patient.
Yes. Well, Eric Holder said, we're at a moment of reckoning in America. Too many in the Senate failed our democracy tonight. Others of us now must commit ourselves to the action that will strengthen and restore that democracy, or we risk losing it. Mm-hmm. I mean, I keep saying we can only do what we can do. And when I hear people that I respect, like, you know, Gwen Ifill and Latasha Brown, re-energized in this fight, that's what I got to do, right? Because, yeah.
Yes, Stephanie, and this is my point. It is, why is it every single time it falls on Black people to save America? Why is it? Why is it that we have to hear from all these Black leaders? Why aren't white people sitting here saying, and I know there are a lot of white people who are in this camp, but here's the deal. There are more of you. And so at the end of the day, it is so unfair to come to Black people and go, well, what are you going to do about democracy?
Yeah.
Because we didn't create the problem. Yeah. We are the oppressors.
John Fugelsang said it. It's dead inside white women. And I, as a dead inside white woman, not about that. I'm not dead inside about voting and democracy, but other stuff. Brian tweeted, GOP plus mansion plus cinema. The American Senate has never, ever voted without upholding the filibuster. Amy Klobuchar, except for the 160 times they have. Yeah. I mean, Frangela, you know, Chris just said, Kristen Sinema is racist, and you just went on Twitter and said you are right. I mean, I'm always okay about calling people that, but you know what? Someone said it best on Twitter. I think they said, when you do the work of racists, you're racist.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I don't know how else you can put it. They knew what they were doing, right?
Oh, absolutely. They got rid of the filibuster. They made an exception for the debt ceiling. What is that? Like a month ago? Like, I mean, this. It's absolutely just racism, and I can no longer hear we are protecting our majority by losing. Like, I don't understand. We don't have a majority. We have 48 senators.
Yes.
That's what we have.
Yeah. And it's all we need to do is get two. There are so many pick-upable seats, including Val Demings, Tim Ryan. Who's the other one I keep forgetting? That's a very winnable seat.
Okay, yeah.
Ron Johnson's in trouble.
Yes, yes.
I like the word pick-upable.
But with the curtsy and the FU ring, Allison tweets, ask Kyrsten Sinema as she left the floor after casting her vote against changing the Senate rules what she thinks on next steps, what she thinks next steps on voting rights are. Have a nice night, she said. I mean, Noel Kassler said, there's something very off about Kyrsten Sinema. The stories don't add up, from her childhood, the tale of living in an abandoned gas station, the Mormon years, the divorce, all the time she voted with the GOP before this, from predatory lending bills to killing wage increases. Malcolm Nance said it. He said she's going to flip to Republican. I mean, there she is in a red dress, shaking Republicans' hands that rushed over to shake her hand after voting down voting rights, right?
She's not going to flip. She's going to take off her jacket and show you her uniform. That's the thing. She's gonna style her hair and put on her hood, so we officially know who she with.
That, well, Noel Castler said it. You know what you call folks that show up in red suits and vote with Republicans? Republicans. I mean, I don't know what her game is anymore. I don't care. She's not even up in 22. We need to focus on 22. This one, Kyrsten Sinema's favorability among Democrats in Arizona has fallen to a new low of 8%. 80% of Arizona Democrats view her favorably, unfavorably, excuse me. And I don't think she's going to win as a Republican. So I maybe her game is as delusional as they're reporting, that she thinks she's going to be president in 2024.
I don't know what she thinks, and I hesitate to even insult the process of cognition by suggesting she has.
Yes, exactly. All right. By the way, can I just say, I thought this was extraordinary. Just in all this talk about income inequality that we've been talking about all week, a professor at Wharton, this is where your friend Ivanka, soon to be subpoenaed, Ivanka, mm-hmm. all the Trumps went, is Wharton School. You know, I asked Wharton students, she's a professor there, what they thought the average American worker makes per year. 25% of them thought it was over six figures. One of them thought it was $800,000 a year. Really not sure what to make of this. The real number is $45,000 a year is the average income of an American. But I mean, it's just, it's where their sort of their mindset is, and what, when, you know, how arrogant is that? And they ask Mitch McConnell, what are you going to do when you take back power? If you take back power, he goes, oh, good question. I'll let you know when we do it. Like, they're so arrogant. They don't, I mean, tax cuts for the rich. That's what they're going to do. Help the top 1%, like they always do.
I think they're going to get rid of the filibuster. Right. That's what I think they're going to do.
Yes.
Yeah. And so, and here we are, you know, steadily begging, you know, Republicans to have a conscience, to act right. They don't have a plan for anything. And I agree. We have got to get all of our Democrats out here in America talking about what we want to give to do for voters.
Yeah.
Because Republicans don't have a plan.